In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at standby mode on the iPhone, or what I like to call nightstand mode. Basically, what this does is this will turn your iPhone into a nightstand. We can have the date, the time, the weather. We can have it just a clock up there. We can change the colors of this. This is what nightstand mode is. Now, what I'm going to do is show you how you can change what is shown here, or how we can change the colors, and basically how it all works. But before we get started, if you do find this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, or even visit danstutorials.com. I have a lot more videos over on danstutorials.com. It's not dance tutorials, it's dance tutorials. You wouldn't want to see me dance. All right, let's take a look at standby mode, or what I like to call nightstand mode on the iPhone. All right, so first thing that we need to do is we need to make sure that it is turned on. We do have a few settings for this. So let's first take a look at the settings for it, how we can turn it on and turn on all the features before we actually go and show how it all works. So I'm going to go over to my iPhone here. And first thing that we need to do is we need to go to the settings app. So I'm going to open up my settings app here. And then what you're going to see, I'm using iOS 17, and I have tested this with iOS 18. You're not going to see any drastic changes here, at least from what I can tell. So when you swipe up here, what you're going to see here is standby. This is where we set it all up. So let's go ahead and tap on it. Take a look. First thing that we want to do is we want to make sure that it is turned on. If this isn't turned on, you're not going to get that standby mode. So let's go ahead and make sure it's turned on. Then, do we want it to show notifications? Do you like to see those notifications at night? I personally don't, so I'm just going to turn that off. When I'm sleeping, I don't want to have those notifications. When it is on, you can set it to show the preview on a tap only. So the only way you're going to see the preview of the notification is when you tap it. But when I'm sleeping, I don't want to see any notifications. So I'm just going to leave that off. And then we have display here. Now we do have a few options for display. So let's go ahead and tap on that. The first thing is when do we want the display to turn off? When it is in that standby mode, the display will turn off automatically. That's how I like to have it set. But we can also have it just after 20 seconds, or not even turn off at all. Again, I like to have it as automatic. When it is on automatic, what it's going to do is turn off when the iPhone is not in use, so you're not using it, and the room is dark. It uses the ambient sensor. So if the room is not dark, it is not going to turn off. If the room is dark, then it will turn off as long as you're not using it. Another catch here is it does have to be charging. So you do have to have it plugged in or using a MagSafe charger for this to work. All right, so I have it set to turn off automatically. That's how I like to have it set. And I also like to use night mode. Now with night mode, when the room is dark, and you'll see this shortly, when the room is dark, it's going to put a red tint on the display. So it's not going to be so bright. If the room is not dark, then it's going to turn that off. And again, I'll be able to demonstrate this in a little bit. And then we also have motion to wake. I like to have this on too. Motion to wake, when the display is off, when this is turned on, all you have to do is just kind of wave in front of it. So let's just say you roll over. Well, my hand just waved in front of the phone. Guess what it's going to do? It's going to turn on in that night mode, so it's not going to be so bright, and I can easily see what time it is. And what it's going to do then is turn off automatically. Maybe a couple hours later, I roll over, I want to see what time it is. Again, all I have to do is just kind of make some kind of a motion so the Apple phone will see me, the iPhone will see me move some way. It doesn't work with the Apple Watch, it just notices motion movement. Or what you can do is tap the nightstand. I like the motion there. Again, when I move, it's going to turn on into night mode, and it's going to turn off automatically. So those are the different settings that we have for it and how I usually have it set up. So now that we know how to set it up, let's take a closer look at this standby mode. So what I'm going to do now is go turn my iPhone horizontal. This is what you need to do. And again, you do need to make sure that it's charging. You can use MagSafe or you can plug it in. So my iPhone is charging and it's horizontal. So guess what we're going to see here when we look at my iPhone? We're going to see nightstand mode. So Let's first take a look at what happens when I dim the light. So I'm going to turn the lights off here. Remember how I said it would turn into a red tint? Let's toggle the lights and watch what happens. After a few seconds, this is going to turn red. And there it is. So now it's not going to be so bright. Now, what do you think is going to happen when I turn the lights back on? Well, let's find out. It notices that the lights are on, and it puts it back into the brighter mode, not that red tint mode. So that is all automatic. Another thing that it will do is it will turn, let's go ahead and toggle the lights. Remember, it has to be in a dark room. I want to demonstrate the motion now. So now my standby mode is turned off. You can't see my iPhone. It's just a black screen. But now watch what happens when I wave my arm up here. You can see it here, and there it is. It just came back to life. And now what it's going to do is it's going to turn off after a few seconds because I'm not moving anywhere and the lights are off. And now it is off. So now I roll over again. So I just like, oh, I'm rolling over. And it comes back to life. So that's that motion sensor and how that works. Actually, it's not the motion sensor. You can use motion. You can bang on the nightstand. But generally what it's doing is it's just kind of watching, you know, for any movement. And when it sees movement, it'll turn that display back on. And then it'll turn it back off after a few seconds again. All right, so now we're looking at my standby mode. Let's take a look at how we can customize this. Now, basically what we have is three different types of display. Right here, this one here is a dual widget. So we have a widget here, which we can change, and we have a widget here, which we can change. To change them, we just swipe. So I'm just swiping up and down here, and I can do the same thing over here. And what that will do is that allows me to change what is shown there. So I just swipe up and down to change those two widgets. Now, if I swipe to the left or right, it changes the complete style of that standby mode. So I swipe to the left. Now I'm looking at my photo mode. I swipe to the left again. And now I'm looking at like a world clock. What do you think is going to happen when I swipe up and down here? Remember how with the widgets we could change the style? Well, when I swipe up and down here, I can change the style again. And again, all of this changes to red when the lights are out. So I could go over to this clock here. I turn the lights out. Watch what happens after a few seconds. It will turn red. So it's easier to see in the middle of the night. There it is. And then I turn the lights back on. And it's going to change back to that blue. But maybe you don't like the blue. You can also change the color of this. In order to do that, what we do is we just tap and hold on it. And now what you're going to see is this little white circle here. When I tap on that white circle, I can go and change the color. And we can do this on different clocks. So I'm just going to tap on the X here. And we're going to go to this one here. I want to change the color. I tap on this. And now I can change that color as well. So all of these here, we can change the color there. And when I'm done, I just tap on done. And now I have that clock. So I swipe up and down to change the style of the clock. I swipe to the left or right to change the style of the standby mode, photo mode, and I can select which photos are shown in here. And then over here, it shows my two widgets and I swipe up and down to view the widgets. If I tap and hold, I can also set if I want smart rotate on, so it's going to change automatically. Maybe it's going to show the weather in the morning automatically, or maybe my calendar. It'll show that in the morning automatically based on what I do. Or I can just turn that off altogether, and then it's going to be just whatever I set it to. Now, personally, what I like to do is I like to have it set to this one here. This one's kind of fun, so I just like to have it set to that one. So that is what standby mode, or what I like to call nightstand mode, is. Basically, we just have to make sure that our iPhone is plugged in, so it needs to be charging, or at least plugged in, and we turn it horizontal. Once we do that, it'll go into nightstand mode automatically. We do need to make sure that this is on in the settings app. It's called standby. So once we have it on and we turn it horizontal and it's plugged in, we're going to get this nightstand. When it is dark, it'll automatically turn red, so it's not so bright in the middle of the night. Turn the lights on, it turns back to its normal colors. We can easily switch what is shown just by swiping to the left or right or up and down. And when you use multiple widgets, the display for multiple widgets, you can set what widgets are shown in the nightstand mode or standby mode. And again, I am testing this, or I'm using this with iOS 17, but I've tested it with iOS 18. And the good news is you're not going to need to change anything when you go to iOS 18, at least not with this feature here. Every update includes multiple feature updates. Well, the good news is with standby mode, as far as I can tell, there aren't any changes to it. So that's how we use standby mode on the iPhone. Again, if you found this helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, or what you can do is check out, or I should say, and what you can do, I would appreciate if you like the video and subscribe to my channel, but also check out danstutorials.com. Again, I have a lot more videos over on danstutorials.com. So that's how we work with standby mode on the iPhone.